live from Bar University. I'm Nat.
I'm Erin.
We are final year students at Bar University, and we have been embarking on a project for the past 8 weeks.
To make these five pieces that we're about to show you.
We have formed our own company. We are named Semper Versa, standing for ever changing, always creating.
So we have this module where we have each become a company member. So I'm choreographer, one of the choreographers.
I'm company manager, and we have teams ranging from education to media.
Social media.
To rehearsal everything. Directors, everything that you can think of that's involved in making a company. This is our first live stream ever, and we have one technician, Rob Gossett.
Rob Gossett, who's made this possible, otherwise it wouldn't have been happening. So it's been really amazing. We've managed to not only make a live performance with a few very socially distanced people in here, but we also made a film and this live stream that you're watching now, hopefully.
We have been in collaboration with other dance companies too, from James Wilton Dance, to
Impermanence and Untold Dance Theatre.
And have two works from our students of our own company. So to introduce James's piece.
Okay, so the piece that you will see in a minute is called Vacation. It's been made by James Wilton Dance. James Wilton himself came in and did an intensive with us for 5 days. And we made the whole piece within those 5 days. So I will read you the programme note. The piece was supposed to be purely about movement and freedom. However, much like 2020, it became weirder and darker as time went on. Finally arriving at a place that feels like a mirror of the year, angry, unsettling, and disturbing. So that is Vacation. We have to give you a little warning. There are strobe lightings throughout the show. There are in this piece, in the middle piece, and in the last piece.
And without further ado,
please enjoy
Vacation.
Thank you.
Hi there, sorry, we're a little bit out of breath. Just
doing the piece, obviously.
So hi, my name's Ella.
And I'm Evie. We hope you all enjoyed the piece you just saw by James Wilton Dance.
So we are two of the student choreographers from Sampa Versa.
We are also company dancers in the shows. Yeah.
So the next piece you're about to watch.
So this is a piece we've created with half of the Sampa Versa cast. Our piece is called Enigmatic. Sorry, just trying to catch my breath. Ella and I have been working together with the company dancers for the last 8 weeks to try and bring together this piece with the dancers.
Yeah, we've been working very collaboratively with them. That was really important for us to involve them as much as possible. That was definitely sort of a strong ethos within our little company. Just a week after we found out that we were choreographers, we had to pitch our idea.
So that was very nerve-wracking to be having to go straight from your choreographers to now being like, next week you're producing and creating a piece.
But yeah, it was all worth it because we're really, really proud of what we have achieved.
Yes.
So our initial idea sort of stemmed from this idea of an interior and exterior presence and how we can sort of project that to you as an audience. And this idea of fight or flight. So, Evie.
Yes, we'd just like to give a quick shout out because obviously this is all live streamed, which is amazing, first time. Mm-hmm. So we've got people in Germany, France, all over the UK, Scotland, England, Wales and Ireland, and many more places, which we'll find out later on. So we're really excited to be able to reach more people than we would initially. So one mm-hmm. of those restrictions was actually amazing.
Exactly. Evie, I've got a question for you.
Yeah.
What would you say was the most challenging part of our process?
There were many challenges, but I think, obviously, with the new restrictions, one of them being, like, masks, obviously, and then socially distancing in the space and how close we can get to each other. Mm-hmm. But even though there was all these different challenges, they actually came as a great opportunity mm-hmm. for our creativity mm-hmm. and brought new aspects to us that we didn't even think would be possible and amazing at all to even create. It gave us a whole new possibility. So even though we challenges, we use them to our strengths and our abilities to help guide mm-hmm. the piece.
Definitely.
I think we're ready. So I hope you enjoy our next piece and I hope you enjoy the rest of the show as well. Here is Enigmatic.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Pupils in your eyes get larger to see better.
Hello, it's me again. I hope you're really enjoying the show so far. This next piece is called Isadora, Isadora. It's been choreographed by Rosanna Anderson and Peter Clements. So they came in and did 4 weeks with us, so that's four sessions, and we made this whole piece. Rosanna Anderson is from Impermanence, and she worked in collaboration with Peter Clements, who is an actor. Now, not lots of us are very used to doing text, but Peter Clements came in, and he was amazing with us and really helped us explore how we could use text in this piece. So it's based on Isadora Duncan's manifesto. Now, for those of you that don't know, Isadora Duncan was a choreographer and dancer and a real pioneer for a lot of contemporary dance. And we also have work based off of Gertrude Stein. Now, Gertrude Stein was a poet and novelist who lived in France with Picasso. And it's amazing. She uses a lot of repetition in her poetry, and I wonder if you could see that in the piece. So we've really, really enjoyed working in this new way. We made a piece so quickly, and it's one of my favorite pieces. It's the only piece I'm in. So that's why, maybe. But I do love performing it. It's so fun, and it's really fun to just explore new text. So what we did was, we got given some of Gertrude Stein's poems, and we were asked to base movement off of the repetitions. We asked to place a movement for certain words, and that is where some of the initial movement ideas came from. And I hope that you might be able to see that also. It's really, really interesting and detailed piece. Isadora Duncan was, as I said, she has this manifesto about contemporary dance and where it's going in its future and what's going to happen to dance. And she basically lists a whole variety of things that she believes is going to happen to the dance world. And I believe that many of them have happened. So she was a very, very smart woman. Yes, so I hope that you're going to enjoy this piece by Peter Clements and Rosanna Anderson, working with Semper Versa. Yes. Here is Isadora, Isadora. Please enjoy. The dancer of the future. The movement of waves, of winds, of the earth is ever in the same lasting harmony. We do not stand on the beach and inquire of the ocean what was its movement in the past and what will be its movement in the future. We realize that the movement peculiar to its nature is eternal to its nature. Only the movements of the naked body can be perfectly natural. And the movements of man will be natural and beautiful like those of the free animals. The dance should simply be, then, the natural gravitation of the will of the individual, which, in the end, is no more nor less than a human translation of the gravitation of the universe. What ideal does the ballet express?
Thank you. What ideal does a ballet express?
To express what is the most moral, healthful, and beautiful in art. This is the mission of the dancer, and to this I dedicate my life. These flowers before me contain the dream of a dance. It could be named
The Light Falling on White Flowers.
It is a prayer, this dance. Each movement reaches in long undulations to the heavens, becomes part of the eternal rhythm of the spheres. Are alike. The dancer of the future will be one whose body and soul have grown so harmoniously together that the natural language of that soul will have become the movement of the body. She will not belong to a nation, but to all humanity. She will dance not in the form of nymph, nor fairy, nor coquette, but in the form of woman in her greatest and purest expression. She shall dance the freedom of woman.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Celeste.
You've met me, I'm Erin again.
We hope you're enjoying the show so far. I'm one of the student choreographers.
I'm also a student choreographer. We made this next piece together. Mm-hmm. We called it Out Through the Moon.
Mm-hmm.
It started initially with the ideas being based on fairy tales and folklore.
Mm-hmm.
twisted kind of fairy tales, natural things, foresty things.
Earthy, very earthy.
Yeah.
So I found this book called East of the Sun and West of the Moon. And it had...
Sorry, we just came from a piece.
It had illustrations in it by Kay Nielsen, and we both just fell in love with the illustrations.
Yes.
They were so detailed beautiful, and they had all these beautiful lines and shapes and
colours and characters and emotions to them.
So that's really where the initial ideas stemmed from for this piece you're about to see. And in this book, there was a line, and it was, out he stepped, and there was the wolf waiting for him. Mm-hmm. And I think that's where a lot of ideas came from after that.
That word waiting, that feeling of waiting, we played with that a lot during the process. Mm-hmm. So there are some movements which suggest perhaps an anticipation for something that's going to come, or maybe an expectation that something's going to happen, but it maybe never does.
So from this waiting, we then sort of played with ideas of focus and relationships and connections within the group.
Mm-hmm. And that came from the characters in the images as well.
Yeah, so we did this.
Playing with focus.
Playing with focus a lot, and that's kind of where the piece developed to, is all these, this group of people with a real individuality, but a real connection still within the whole group. Mm-hmm. And that's where the piece has developed to.
Yeah. I have a question for you, Erin.
Go for it, Celeste.
What was your favourite moment of the whole process of making Elf Flew the Moon?
So my favourite moment was probably last Tuesday.
Yeah.
It was a great day. We had a really late rehearsal from 8 to 10 p.m.
Me and Erin and I both like to play and then in the last few days just...
Put it together.
So that's what happened on Tuesday.
And it was just amazing to see all of this ideas, everything we've been doing for these 8 weeks that we've had just come together. It was a real, it's okay. Yeah. A great moment.
That was a great moment.
Just to see everything come together so nicely. Mm-hmm. And I hope you think it's nice too.
Yeah.
What was your favourite moment, Sal?
I think my favourite was probably one of the first tasks we did with our lovely dancers. The task was based off the images from the book, based off the illustrations, and it brought so much material and so much emotion and feeling and storyline and characters through just doing that one task. So I think that was a moment where I was really like, oh, this is what we can,
this is what
we can do. Wow, this is what we can do with it. Shout out, yeah. We'd also like to mention, of course, you know already, we're lucky to have a few people in the theatre with us. We've also got lots and lots of people around the world. We've got people in Greece.
In Lithuania and Italy.
And Latvia.
Yeah.
And as well as other places.
And lots of other places. And we're just so happy that what we've managed to do here can be so expansive and reach so
it's
many
amazing.
People.
It's
really exciting to be part of.
Yeah, it's a huge thing.
It's the first time we've done it.
Exactly.
It's incredible, and we're so happy. So we really hope you enjoy this piece.
Yes.
Our dancers have worked so hard, and
we're so proud of them all.
So proud of them. So please enjoy Out Flew the Moon.
Enjoy.
Thank you.
Hello, hope you all enjoyed the show so far. This will be our last piece, unfortunately. But it's choreographed by Vicky Hearn, who is a lecturer at Barksdale University. She also has her own dance company called Untold Dance Theatre, and she's worked very closely with the dancers from the very beginning. Anyone who knows Vicky will know that this will be a very Vicky piece, with a lot of floor work, a lot of earthy, rebels against the world kind of thing. So her piece is called Underworld, and Underworld explores the utopian ideology of an underworld. This earth is forever encased of darkness and has stilled. However, dwelling in the depths of the signs of human existence, resisting, growing and expanding upwards towards the surface. So it kind of reflects the time that we're going through and the challenges that we've been facing as a whole world. And coming to university, like back from lockdown, was a challenge that we kind of all took on, that we all accepted, but wanted to be back in the space creating. And despite everything that we've been against, I think we've taken everything on as a company exceedingly well. And despite being in masks, despite being not allowed any contact work, which we were all looking forward to, we really, really faced the challenges that we had and wanted to do this project together and have made something quite amazing. This work requires a lot of punch and a lot of gusto, really. And having to do that in masks, I think, is quite difficult. But I think they've all really faced everything really well. They've been working with Vicky for a long time on this work. So I think it really shows everyone's strength, this piece, and has a lot to show as a company what we've worked for together, really. And I couldn't be prouder as a company manager of overseeing all the work that they've done together, pulled together in amidst everything. Couldn't be more enthused by everything that they have adapted to, everything that they've shown, the resilience that they've shown. And it's amazing what we've produced in just 8 weeks. It's been a process, very long process, but very, very happy and very proud to stand here. I'm not entirely sure if they're ready. I can't see anyone. But I think they're coming, because I'm aware that I'm standing here for a long time talking to you. but I think they're on their way. And I hope that you've enjoyed everything that we've been able to show with you, to share with you today, because it's the first time that we've ever done anything like this, and it's been amazing to share. So here they all come, and introducing Underworld. again, back with my right-hand woman, who I wouldn't have been able to do any of this without. So extremely thank you for all your hard work.
Oh, and thank you to you too. You've been amazing. And thank you to everyone watching here and at home. We're really, really excited that we could share it with so many people.
Who wouldn't have accessed any of this before. Yeah. So it's been an amazing opportunity for us to be able to share it with you guys at home. And it's been an amazing experiment, which we had no idea would work out like this. So.
And yeah, we're really, really proud. And we're glad we could share it.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming.
And thank you for watching.
Really good weekend.
Thank you. Goodbye.